بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. In chapter 11, we will talk about the concept of recursion. Recursion is mainly a method that it will call itself. So we will not use any loop, but we will have the sense of having repeated iteration. We will start our example with recursion with find output. So let's assume we have the following. From the main method, we have to find the value of x as equal fact between a bracket 3, and this is actually a method. The method is written such that the name of the method is fact. It will take an integer n and it will return an integer. At the beginning of the method, we have to output n. If the value of n is less than 1, we have to return 1. Otherwise, I have to return the value of n multiply by the method again of n minus 1. And here why we call it as a recursive method, because here the method itself I have to call it. So if the value of n initially is 5, we will send later on 4, and then we will send 3. So we will keep calling the method till we reach the value of 1, which will be the last thing. So let's start with trying the output. So from the main, we have the following. I have to find the value of x, and this is equal to the method fact, and I have to send the parameter 3. So it means from the main, we have to go to the method, and I have to send the value of n as a 3. Which means here, if we think about it, this is my first call of the method, and we are sending the value of n as a 3. Now we need to execute all the statements in the method. The first one is output the line of the value of n. So the first output we will have the value 3. So let's have the output here. So the first value we will have it as a 3. And then I have to go and check the condition. If n is less than or equal to 1, the value of n currently is a 3, so it's not 1. We will have to go to the else. In the else part, it says we have to do the following. We have to return the value of n, the current value of n as a 3, so I'll have to say 3. And then I have to multiply by the method again of n minus 1. So I have to multiply by the method again of 3 minus 1, which is 2. So now you notice that we don't have an exact number. If it was written like this, that you have to return a 3, it means a 3 will be the result, and we will take a 3 to the mean, and this is will be the result. But what is happening actually, as I'm saying, return n multiply by the method again, and change n such that it will be 3 minus 1, which is 2. Now what do we have? We have to find what is the value of fact of 2. So we have to find it there, and from there we can just find what is the result. Which means now again I have to call the method, so we will go and have a second call. And we will send the value of n as 2. So it means now I will call the same method again, but I will change the value of n. So here it means the value of n we have to send is 2. So now this is n and the value as 2, because we are coming there. And then I'm changing the value of n. Again, I have to start my method from the beginning. What is the value of n? The current value of n is 2. Go and check if n is 1. It's not. Go to the else part. And the else part I have to say return n multiply by fact of n minus 1. So here we have to say return n. The current value of n is 2, so we will say return 2 multiply by fact of n minus 1. Again, the current value of n is 2, 2 minus 1 is 1. Still, we don't have a final result. Still, I have to find what is the value of this. So I have to call the method again. And this will be the third call, and we will change the value of n. So again, I'll have to go and call the method and change the value of n to be 1 and re-execute my method. Output the value of n, so the output will be 1. Check the value of n. Is it 1? Currently, the value of n is 1. So we reach the end. I have to return 1. So I'll have to say here return and the value of n as 1. Now we have an answer and we can take it to the previous call. We have to remember that this is a recursive call. So when we just finish, when we reach the last, I shouldn't go back to the beginning of the main method. We have to see that from the main method, we had a sequence of calls. So from the main method, we have call number 1 and then call number 2 and then call number 3. So when you finish call number 3, do not jump to the main. This is not the correct thing. What I have to do, I have to go one step back. So I have to take this result 1 to the previous call, to the place where we call the method fact of 1. So the result of fact of 1 is what we found as 1. Now I have to say go and return 2 multiply by 1. 2 multiply by 1 is 2. Take the result of 2 and take it to the previous call. So here 2 multiply by 1 is 2. Take the result there and this says will be as 2. Multiply 3 by 2, which is 6. Now we will go to the main and we have the result as 6. And this is will be saved as our x value. So here when we change, we will go back to the main and the value of x will be 6. And then we will output the value of x. So the value of x will be as 6. So the output will be 3, 2, 1 and then x equals 6. The idea of recursive method is you have to call the method several times till you reach the end and then you have to go one step back. So here we have two cases. The first case is if n equal 1, I will have to return 1 and this will be the end of my recursive method. Just like what we notice here, if the value of n, we reach the value of n is 1, we return 1. So we don't have any more calls, we'll just have to go back one step. That's why we call this one as base case. So this will be my base case. And this is the case that we have to end our recursive method. The other one, we have the other calling of the method and we call it as a general case. The meaning of general case is this is the case where you have to continue calling your method. And here you notice that we have to say fact of n minus 1. So again, I'm calling the same method fact. And I will send a value of n, but I will change it by saying n minus 1. So what we did here, it was something similar to calculating factorial. So if I need to know the factorial of a 3, I'll have to simply to say 3 multiply by 2 multiply by 1. Or we can simply say 3 factorial equal 3 factorial, 3 multiply by 2 factorial. And 2 factorial is 2 multiply by 1 factorial. And 1 factorial is actually 1. And then the result will be 1 multiply by 2 multiply by 3, which is 6. So the idea here, if you have any number and you need to calculate the factorial of this number, you have to say take n and multiply it by the factorial of n minus 1. Decrement the number by 1. How long you have to keep? You have to keep going. And because you are decrementing the number till you reach 1. If you reach 1, the factorial of 1 will be 1. And here what we did here, it was mentioned that if you reach 1, this is the base case and the result will be as 1. If the value of n is not 1, then you have to take the value of n and you have to take the factorial of n minus 1. So we have always a base case. This will be the end of recursive method. And always we will have to call the method again. And this will be the general case. One small thing always we have to remember when it comes to general cases that the value of n should be changed. So let's assume the following. Assume by mistake the value of n here minus 1. And instead of saying n minus 1, we just say I have to send the value of n, fact of n. So what will happen in this case? It means in the first call you will have n as a 3. When you call, you will say multiply 3 by fact, not 2, because I'm not saying n minus 1, I'm saying also use the same n. So the next call, n again will be 3, and then in the third call, n will be 3, and you will continue like an infinite recursive call. So you will never reach an end. So always I have to remember, when we call our method, our recursive method, the parameter should be changed. So here I have n, so I'll have to say n minus 1 in order to reach my base case, in order such that once I change n minus 1, I will reach at the end the value of n as 1.